This girl was suffering from autism. She was a rare talent in kung fu. After watching a kung fu movie, she not only remembered all of the skills, but also knew how to practice them. In the movie, people used a wooden pole to practice. Zen covered the pillar with blankets and then practiced on it. She seriously practiced kung fu though she was very young. After a while, she now could easily make a boy fall down. Zen's mom bought green apples. Zen did not eat and take those apples to practice kung fu. She kept on practicing, days by days, years by years. Time flies, Zen was now 20 years old. To earn more money for the family, Zen and Moon together performed kung fu on the street. Her ball-catching skill was incredibly fast. Everyone gave her applauses. When on break, Zen also performed her eating candy special technique. Zen earned a lot of money through such interesting performances, but also attracted the troublesome gangsters. Seeing their mates being beaten, other gangsters stormed right in. Zen just swiftly dodged, let the gangsters hit, and knocked down each other. Those gangsters could not keep up with Zen. One of them was kicked in the face and fainted. That combat made Zen famous. However, since that combat, Zen could not continue to earn money by perform on the street. The gangsters kept on making trouble whenever they saw Zen. Things were getting worse when Zen knew her mother had cancer. After a while, they had spent all their money on her hospital fee. Zen took her mother home to rest. Until one night, Moon ran into mother's notebook. Inside the notebook, the mother noted down the bosses who owed her money. It turned out that those bosses were supported by Yakuza, so they usually owed the salary of the mother. Debt must be paid, that was a normal thing. Besides, this amount of money could save the mother's life. So the next day, Zen and Moon went to find those bosses without telling their mother. The first debtor was the boss of an ice workshop. He looked up and saw a boy and a girl. They dared to find him, and asked him pay the debt. Without saying a word, he ordered the security to kick the boy and the girl out. Zen was about to fight back but was dragged away by Moon. That night, Zen was not able to sleep. Finally, she decided to come to the ice workshop alone. The gangsters were all around her, quickly took down Zen. At this moment, there were a lot of kung fu movie scenes continuing to appear in Zen's mind. She then remembered the pale face of her mom. The anger inside Zen started to build up. The fighting spirit of Zen took over her mind. She stood up and did a side kick. Zen now was completely a warrior. Other gangsters rushed towards Zen, but they could not withstand two hits. Just for a moment, all of the taken down gangsters were screaming on the floor in pain. The boss was the only man standing. He intended to do a sneak attack on Zen, but he finally got beaten up so hard by Zen. Finally, Zen could take all her mother's salary. Since then, Zen understood that she could only do justice through violence. Whenever Zen watched a kung fu movie, she would keep on rewinding it over and over. She absorbed every skill and move, one by one. She had been practicing her speed with candies. Every candy she ate, she had to do it as fast as possible. Day by day, Zen became extremely good at fighting. She could go to the debtors and ask them to pay by herself. Zen and Moon came to a wood workshop. The boss immediately took out the money. Was it too easy? No, it wasn't. The boss put the money back in a pocket, and then threw it to a gangster. Moon came to the gangsters. They started to fool him around. They threw the money bag back and forth until Zen rushed forward, caught the money, and kicked a gangster in his face. Here came the trouble. Moon dragged Zen back and quickly ran into the warehouse. The gangsters were chasing behind. Zen used her swift body, dodged hit by hit, and took down those gangsters one by one. In the middle of the warehouse fight, Zen cleverly used strategy. She quickly opened a cabinet's door, hit the gangster's groin. Then she opened the upper door to take him down. Another gangster rushed towards, Zen dodged his hit, threw him inside the cabinet, and closed the door. The boss saw all of his gangsters were taken down. He had to act himself. Zen lowered her body, dodged the boss's hit. Then she jumped up and did a middle air kick. The boss fainted for a long time. Zen successfully took her mother's salary. She quickly had enough money for the treatment by using the violent way. The mother gradually recovered. This made Zen's smile come back on her face. Since then, Zen's daily routine was taking care of her mother in the early morning and coming to the debtor at night. One night, the mother knew everything when she saw many bruises on Zen's body. She sadly hugged Zen and cried. The next day, the mother called Moon and Zen to come and scolded at them. She said that she rather died than risked her kid's life. Moon promised not to bring Zen with him when going to see the debtors to calm the mother. After that, he went to the debtor all alone. Big and serious trouble came at this time. A mafia kidnapped Moon to threaten Zen's mother. It turned out that, long ago, Zen's mother used to be a Yakuza. In a mission, she fell in love with a mafia named Masashi, who was Zen's father. Because of love, Zen betrayed her gang, and was punished by being removed the leg's tendon. Zen's father was taken back to Japan. Recent years, the mother took Zen with her everywhere. She had been away from the underground for so long, but she could not get away from the Yakuza's pursuit. This time, the mother decided to fight back. She took Zen, stormed in the Yakuza headquarters. She would do whatever it takes to get Mume out. At the same time, Masashi, who was in Japan, received a challenge letter from Yakuza. Due to the rule and also due to his family, Masashi decided to come back. All of the gangs gathered at a kung fu club. Old and new feud must all be solved that day. Zen attacked first. A group of gangsters were taken down quickly. At this moment, a man came towards Zen. He seemed weak, but it turned out he was the toughest man. Mafia called him Monkey because his skill was unique and incredibly fast. Opponents usually could only saw his shadow, and then was taken down. In the eyes of a kung fu genius like Zen, every skill of Monkey was in slow motion. In the matter of minute, Zen had absorbed his ultimate skill. They started to fight. Every time Monkey attacked, Zen could see it in advance and dodge it. Finally, they directly hit each other. Monkey was fainted by his own ultimate skill. Zen also exhaustedly laid down on the floor. Now, a tall man came in the club. He was a Japanese martial art master, Zen's father, Masashi. The Yakuza all drew out their sword and prepared to fight. Masashi took out his gun and killed those Yakuza one by one. After running out of bullet, he started to fight with his bare hands. Then picked up a sword and did deadly strikes. In the blink of an eye, half of the Yakuza was taken down. In the middle of the fight, number 8, the Yakuza leader did a sneak attack. Masashi's wife stormed out to take the hit for him. They had been separating for 20 years. The moment they reunion, they had to say the forever farewell. Masashi became as angry as ever, killed all the number 8 subordinates. Masashi himself had been injured by many hits. He fell down on the ground. Seeing her mother had been killed, her dad had been serious injured, all of Zen could think of at that moment were revenge. She picked up 2 scabbards. She used sword skills and furiously beat down those Yakuza. Number 8 dragged Zen's mother body away, intended to escape. Zen was chasing behind. Number 8 was about to take the gun out, but Zen kicked the gun away. Zen kept on hitting number 8 with punches and kicks. Number 8 could not fight back. He jumped to the opposite building to escape. He held on the billboards to climb down. Zen kept on chasing behind. Others Yakuza had come to help number 8. On the narrow edge of the porch, Zen took down the Yakuza one by one. Finally, there was only number 8 left. Zen stormed towards him, beat his ass out, and pushed him down. He fell down the floor and died. After the intense fight, Zen killed all of the Yakuza, successfully revenged. But her mother forever could not wake up. She hugged her mother's body, cried like a baby. Masashi came and hugged Zen tightly. Since then, Zen and her father live a reclusive life. Many years later, they were said to have a peaceful life in Japan. The world keeps on changing, and we cannot hold back our love for too long.